if they might enter like an area that the settlers like claim this is like their own land, and it's easy for them to call the soldiers and, you know, to arrest the Palestinians. So when they arrest the Palestinians, another long story, they took them to the military bases and then to Israeli police station in the settlements of Tel Arba, and they never released any Palestinians until he must like pay fees just like to be released. So also during like the actions at the demonstration, also, you know, the fabric like the activist and so on. So this is the policy. You know, there is kind of plan how just to push the Palestinians just to leave. So in the 70s, you know, they divided this area for two different parts. One part, which goes in the south, they declared as kind of firing zone for the military exercises. And the other part, as you see, along the road 317, you know, they targeted like the villages, just like to confiscate the land and to connect the villages, the settlements with each other. So down the Palestinian villages in the firing zone, there are about 15 Palestinian villages. And sometimes, you know, the army, they use this area in their military exercises, you know, with their tanks and, you know, destroying the Palestinian fields and, you know, used also to invade the villages and, you know, nitrate and also. So, as I said, you know, the goal is to make the life harder and harder for the Palestinians. And in November 1999, there was kind of a eviction order for all these villages that exist in the firing zone. Under this excuse that these villages are existed in the firing zone, and they use like this excuse like to kick them. And at that time, you know, they bring, you know, big military trucks and the big bulldozers, and so they destroy like the villages, and they just put all the Palestinian things, and they threw them to the other side of the road 317. So here in the village of Etwani, it's like out of this order, so we had hosted like most of the Palestinians in this village. And at that time, it was like the beginning of the relationships between us as the Palestinians and the Israelis. So, you know, the Israelis, they started just coming down here to the village, just like, you know, to visit the families who were evicted. And at that time, you know, most of the Palestinians were like kind of confused about, you know, like, you know, Israelis, you know, they are coming down, and, you know. But, you know, little by little, you know, they show like their solidarity, and they would like to help the Palestinians who were evicted, and just to use the legal way and to raise this issue to the Israeli Supreme Court. So with the help of the Israelis, I mean, B'Tselem, Rabbi for Human Rights, and Peace Now, and others, so we managed to just like to raise this issue to the Israeli Supreme Court. So after 3 months of the eviction, in 2000, there was this kind of decision that said the Palestinians have the right to get back to their villages. So it was a very big success for us, you know. So we can say that we started just, you know, organizing our own resistance. Because, you know, there was kind of hope that, you know, we can use the law, you know, to resist all these aggressive rules. So, and as you see, this is a very far and remote area, so there was no media coverage and attention for this and what's going on here. So with the Israelis and then later with the internationals, you know,
we manage just like to raise the issue of the South African Hills in general and what's going on like with the whole violations. So we started with that. I mean, it was like the beginning, you know, really to choose like the effective way, which is like the effective way. It should be like a non-violent one. Why? Because, you know, if you think about the whole situation, what's going on, it's like really a violation for the human rights. You know, all your life, it's like targeted, you know. You have no stability, you have no services, and, you know, you are suffering every day. And this is kind of really provocation for your humanity, you know. And, you know, as a human, you should respond in a violent way. Okay. But if you think deeply, what's the goal of all these aggressive rules and all these violence against the Palestinians pushing the Palestinians forcefully, you know, in order to respond in a violent way? Because, you know, they need excuses to convince, like, the normal Israelis and the whole world that, you know, look, you know, this is the Palestinians, you know, they are violent and they are terrorists and so on. So we started, like, meetings in each village around, you know, and we should, like, create kind of body, you know, to represent the resistance here. As we confirm that, you know, we must choose the nonviolent resistance. So we start since that time, we started just, like, you know, having activists from all over the area. And we started with our relationships with the Israelis and the internationals, and we started really for the real nonviolent resistance since that time and until now. That's right, you know, we are still under the occupation, but, you know, the message is we are still alive people and we'll never give up and we'll never keep the occupation going on in this area. Okay, that's right, we will suffer and we are ready to suffer and we will respond and will resist like in non-violent way.